Hello all, today we can discuss about how to control the motor speed individually through WinCC recipe control. So I am using two controls. One is hinging. During the hinging you can see that 30, 15 and 25 Hz. This is the motor speeds which is running, and we can put the emergency stop also. By setting the emergency stop, all the motors will be idle. And I am just taking into the full load. By providing the full load, you can see it is 40, 45 and 50. We can predefine all the speeds in the recipe controls. So this is the WinCC recipe, and let's see how it's done. So first thing first, we need to put some simple factory elements from here. You can see double tap, and you can see the blower will be first, and I just want to change it. So right click and go to properties. You'll be getting in the general. You can have the other simple factory elements like motors, pumps and everything. So I can search for the motors right here on the simple factory. So you can see all, you can watch in all these in the categories. So motors I'm looking for the motors. I can use any motor I want. So for this time I'm using the normal motor, and this will be my motor. And next, I have to duplicate the motors for 3. I'm going to copy and paste. Control V, and I'm using 3 motors, 1, 2, and 3. Fine. So this is my 3 motors, and I did actually need 3 speedometers for displaying the speed and also displaying the speed in the IO field also. So I just want to take the element from here, and I don't actually need 0 to 100 Hertz. I just need to display only 0 to 50 Hertz. So I just want to go to the properties first, and in the properties I have to use the minimum and maximum scale. The minimum value will be 0 and the maximum value I'm setting it as 50. Okay, 0 to 50, and in the appearance, and you can see everything we can customize on this appearance and the design, layout, text format and the ranges. In the ranges you can set up the high and low range. The normal range it is green, and the warning range will be starting from 30. You can use, and the danger range will be after 40. So you can see this is my slider which is customized to show the speed of 0 to 50, and the warnings will be starting from 30, and the danger zone will be starting from 40 to 50. So you can also duplicate all these things, copy and paste. Okay, so I just created 3 things, and I have to place all this stuff with the motor, 1, 2, and 3. And here comes to 3. And also I just want to put the IO field right here. Here you can place the IO field and duplicate. And duplicating the IO fields for the motor speed monitoring. And I have 3 tags which will be integer tags. I'm going to show you the tags. The tag management window right here. In the tag management you can see, here you can see the HMI tags, and inside the HMI tags you can show the default tag table. We can show you the tag tables. What is M1, M2 and M3. These are the 3 motor tags, which are the data type is integer, because I just want to show the numbers. So all the speed in numbers, so I'm using the integer, and I'm closing this. So everything I can give in the motor. So right click and go for properties. In the animations, I can go for display. So in add a new animation, I just want to dynamize the colors and flashing. I just need to flash my motor when it is running. So I'm just giving the tag as M1, first motor is M1. So the range will be, I have to add range 0 to 999. I'm making it 1 to 999. When it is starting, the speed will be at least 1. So I just need to flash it. So I'm flashing it, yes. Same for the second one also. So be, and the tag should be the tag should be empty. So appearance range, it is I'm using 1299, and flashing will be yes. And also the next one, in this I just want to add a new animation. This will be M3. The range will be starting from same 1 to 999, and yes, and three motors configured, then we can configure the speedometers. So in this have to go for the properties and general the process tag. The process tag for which is the run time shown, the process tag which will be M1, and this will be M2, and next one will be M3. And for this the process tag will be also M1, changing to M2. For this it will be M3. So we just created all this stuff, and we are going to create the exact recipe for all this stuff, all these motors up to our own your customized speed controller speed. So we can go for the recipes right here, double tap and add a new recipe. The name will be hinging means have to run the motor in a specified speed. Display name also hinging, and then the second recipe will be full load. This will be also the display name should be also full load, and I'm selecting the first recipe and have to add three elements. These are my three motors, M1, M2 and M3. These are my three elements, three motors, and the tags I have to add it as M1, the corresponding tags, M2 and M3. So all the tags I have added, and here I can set up the default values. I'm going to add as 25 on the hinging, that will be 25, 15 and 35. These are my customized speeds. You can give any speed you can use. And next thing, have to select the full load condition. Here also I have to add the same elements, which is M1, M2 and M3. The same tags I have to provide here, which will be M1, M2 and here goes with the M3. And default values will be 40, 45 and 38. So these are my default value to be the full load for the whatever it will be, AC or anything. You can use it for the full load condition, and no need to save, just simply close it. And we can set up a emergency stop which I have already configured. I can show you the properties. Inside the properties you can go for events. In the events it's just a button from taken from here. I just change its colors and put the name as emergency stop. And the events you can see have to set the tag on the click. On the events you can select the click and set the tag as tag value output. Okay, set tag, the value will be 0. Have to set the tag M1 as the default value 0, because the if you are setting the default value 0, that will be stopped. Also set tag M2 default value 0. Also set tag M3 default value 0. Everything will be 0. If you want to show, if you want to see it by setting, I have to add a new function right here. I have to add a new function and set type set tag, and have to select the tags from corresponding tag from here, whatever it will be, M1 or M2 or M3, and you can also have the default value to be loaded on it. So that is the set tag. I'm just deleting this, and the final thing will be the recipe control or the recipe view. Have to place my recipe view right here. Have to place this on here so I can easily access the recipe. Simply, we don't need any configuration for the recipe view. You can do click and simply go for the runtime. And during the runtime, you'll be watching the recipe that will be blinking on full load. See, the motor is blinking, and on hinging, you can see the motor speed. And on the emergency stop, I can put everything will be zero. So I didn't given the flashing for the second motor. That's my bad. I'm really sorry about that. Get to the full load again. That will be blinking and set up this speed on the speedometer and the IO field also. 40, 48 at some 38 any speed, sorry. And on the hinging also, that will be individually we can control for the customized speeds and the emergency kill switch also. That's it. Thanks for watching. Bye.